Feeling lost and upset during the coronavirus quarantine? That's where the Wine Fairies of Long Island come in. These amazing men and women have been keeping their communities happy, smiling, and thirst-quenched during the pandemic. So what are the Wine Fairies of Long Island exactly? Well, it all started with the simple act of gifting a bottle of wine to a neighbor during these hard times. Almost like the Tooth Fairy, but for wine. Connie Breyer, the group's creator, started by making little gift bags for her neighbors. Like so many others, she wanted to check on those close to her while staying safe. Breyer never expected her gifts to mean so much to the recipients, nor start a movement. However, it did. Breyer's actions inspired others to do the same for those close to them. Now the presents can include practically everything from snacks to bath bombs, which are delivered at the recipient's house in a dusting. Our group is about giving. The point is about doing something nice for somebody, said Breyer. You put a smile on somebody's face. So many people are having a good time with this, and it's become contagious. Now the entire group is exploding faster than anyone ever predicted. After the trend hit Facebook, it went really viral. Now there are wine fairies all across Long Island. Pamela Deal, one of the organizers, also felt surprised by the rapid growth of the idea. However, in her eyes, it makes sense when you think about it. You just make a little package. Wine, goodies, treats. People do stuff for kids, and you bring it to somebody's doorstep. You can do it anonymously if you want, or you can sign your name to it, Deal said. We're all stuck home with our children. Wine showing up on your doorstep to get you through the day? What's better than that? Most people from the groups like to dress up when they're doing their dusting, and regardless if they're costumed as a turkey with a saddle, a panda, or an actual fairy, they're always welcome visitors. Dressing up as characters, it makes people laugh, have a good time. People enjoy it, and it brightens up their day a little bit, says member Aaron DeStefano. People need to laugh and have a good time, and I feel like that's what we're doing for people. If you want to be part of the fun, it's pretty easy. Make some care packages, don some costumes, the quality of which is not important, and share some smiles in your neighborhood. Risa Fire, who's visited over 400 houses with her husband, has some tips for those beginning. I've pinpointed certain people. People that are going through hard times. Single parents. People that are just not in a good place right now, she said. And I love the reaction that I get. I'll be walking around and people are looking when I go on main streets and I'm dressed as the chicken or the poop. I get a lot of questions and a lot of stares and stuff. And I get a lot of laughs. But it's not just about laughs. Members of the group also collected thousands of dollars amid the pandemic by selling t-shirts. They donated it to various food pantries. If I hadn't started this during COVID-19, it probably wouldn't have taken off because people have busy lives, Bayer said. And once the pandemic passes, she wants this to be a tremendously happy memory that will shine through the bad ones. This is what I hoped it would turn out to be.